We usually think of astronauts in only the most heroic terms, brave women and men in peak physical and mental shape who will risk it all to further humanity's reach into the great beyond. But as the Japanese author Taro Gomi so eloquently put it, everyone poops. And NASA is still looking for the number one way to dispose of number two. When we first started taking baby steps into space, NASA tried to get around the problem by keeping astronauts from having to go entirely. Weightlessness actually makes poop travel through the body faster, so to counteract this for short missions, astronauts ate a low-fiber diet for 3 days before launch. The early days of longer crewed missions had the most crude solution. Apollo astronauts used what was essentially a plastic bag taped to their butts. And yes, the bags were clear, I guess so the astronauts could see if they had the right stuff. It may shock you, but dropping space trow and pinching off a brown asteroid into a bag didn't always go smoothly. Famously, the Apollo 10 mission, the dress rehearsal for the moon landing, and the step before the giant leap for mankind had an unexpected passenger along for the ride. It happened 6 days into the mission. Commander Tom Stafford was the first to notice it, a turd floating around inside the capsule. It happened 6 days into the mission. Commander Tom Stafford was the first to notice it, a turd floating around inside the capsule. Between fits of laughter, the three astronauts on board all denied ownership of said turd, claiming they would have known if they had pooped on the floor, or that their poop was more sticky. Regardless, Stafford stepped up and grabbed the space waste with a napkin. And that is why he was the commander. To this day, no one has owned up to it, but the transcripts of the exchange are public record. My favorite part is that they were at one time marked confidential, presumably to keep the Russians from learning about our top secret butt bag technology. The space shuttle had a more conventional toilet, though it required training with an underseat video camera to master. Yes, space shuttle astronauts were toilet trained twice in their lives. Today, astronauts on the International Space Station have a vacuum-powered toilet to catch any floaters. It even has a seatbelt, probably to keep them in place in a microgravity environment, but maybe in case they have a really intense session, I don't know. But we haven't stopped developing space toilets, and we've got our eyes and tushies on the prize. Yes, there is a prize for a better space loo. Dr. Thatcher Carden is a family doctor, a flight surgeon, and a colonel in the US Air Force. In 2017, he added winner of the Space Poop Challenge to his many prestigious titles. Dr. Thatcher developed a system that allowed astronauts to go to the bathroom while still in their suit, eliminating the need for diapers. The system relies on an airlock at the astronaut's crotch. When the astronaut takes off the cap, a self-closing valve keeps the air from escaping. The astronaut can then insert a tube through the valve that can be used to slide a number of things inside the suit, like an inflatable bedpan, a bidet, wet wipes, even fresh underwear. This technology might not just help astronauts avoid diaper rash, it could be essential if their spacecraft is pierced by debris and they have to spend days inside their suits. For his sanitation innovation, Dr. Carden was awarded $15,000, which is nothing to sniff at. As glamorous as space exploration is, it has a funny way of reminding us that we are still human and still have to solve some very basic human problems. Rockets that get us to Mars are important, but making sure that the first person to set foot on it doesn't track poop on their boot is important too. If this video made you laugh, then I'm sorry, but you have to subscribe. Those are the rules. Poop's not the only problematic waste in space. In 1963, a Mercury capsule had several systems go dark thanks to a leaky pee bag. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time here on Seeker.